Well, there you have it. You had the gospel read to you. Before that, you had the words from Paul in his second letter to the Corinthians. We all recited a psalm together. Before that, a lesson from Lamentations, which wasn't very lamentful, but was rather joyful. So you come to church on a Sunday morning, and you hear the word of God, spoken directly from the scriptures, read directly from the scriptures. And before that, we sang a hymn together. So we get up on most Sunday mornings, sometimes just out of habit, and we come to church. And this is what we do. We hear the word of God, and we sing about it. We sing, hopefully, good hymns full of theology, good theology. And of course, then for some of you, you're taken aback. You see a layman in the pulpit. And you think, what's he doing up there? Well, of course, we all know Pastor Roger Michelson retired. And for the majority of the summer, we do have pulpit supply. So you will have an ordained pastor up here speaking to you. But there are a few Sundays that have to be covered. And so there are a few people like myself who say, well, I'll give it a shot, see if I can fill in, see if I can give you a little insight into the gospel lesson for today or the other lessons that were read. And hopefully, since we're all in this together, deepen our faith. After all, that's what we come to church to do, to deepen our faith. We don't tend to jump up and down, and run up and down the aisles, get all excited, especially not in the Lutheran church. But we do come here because when you think about it, it is a thrill to hear these stories. Think of the thrill of this lady who had been hemorrhaging for 12 years. There's people in this congregation who have suffered from things for 12 years or longer. Think of the thrill of being healed. Of course, she was healed of her physical ailment. But the real miracle, of course, is that she believed in Jesus. So the real miracle is the inheritance or the gift given by grace of eternal life. Think of the thrill that the parents felt when their little daughter was raised from the dead. And some of us can say, I suppose most of us can say, we've never seen that. But yet, we believe in eternal life. We have the thrill of believing that Jesus Christ has done the work for us. And so after this life, we will live forever in perfect bliss. So sometimes it doesn't always seem like when we hear these stories, of course we've all probably heard it for the 100th time maybe this morning. Throughout your lifetime, you've heard this story many times of the lady who touches Jesus and is healed. You've heard Lazarus raised from the dead. You've heard of the daughter of Jairus in this particular story raised from the dead. And doesn't it get a little old sometimes? I mean, I think that's sometimes why our churches aren't splitting at the seams. Is because we think, well, we went to Sunday school, we've heard these stories, but in our own lives, do we feel that? I mean, we get weighed down by a lot of things during the week. You know, we have problems at home, appliances that break. We have people who fall ill, friends and family that fall ill, perhaps friends and families that pass away. And it seems like life gets awfully depressing sometimes. Some people despair and say, where is God in all of this? We look at the news and we see problems with tariffs, and problems with immigration, problems with opioid addiction, all sorts of epidemics. And so we have to ask ourselves, does all this lead to singing the blues? The thrill is gone. You've probably all heard the great song, The Thrill Is Gone. B.B. King sings it very well. Wonderful blues song. You should go down to Peterson or some other nearby town, listen to the Rutabaga Brothers do it. They do a real nice version of it. It starts with a slow, mournful guitar sound, slowly builds. And then Keith Zeller comes in with this gravelly voice and just belts it out. The thrill is gone. And it's a wonderful blues song. And you wonder, why are the blues sort of appealing to us? Well, it's a way for us as human beings to commiserate, because we do have problems. And then we ask ourselves, is it true? Is the thrill gone? What about our church? I thought about this week when I read the gospel lesson and I was thinking about what I would say. Is the thrill gone in our church, Rushford Lutheran Church? And of course, my thought on it, it didn't take me long to think about it. It's an emphatic no. The thrill is not gone. But the thrill isn't always what you think. The thrill isn't something superficial that we get all whooped up about. The thrill is knowing deep in our heart that we have a message. A message that was preached by Pastor Roger Michelson for well over 17 years here. He preached the gospel. And I have no doubt that the supply pastors who will be here during the summer will preach the gospel. They'll preach it from the scriptures, which is the way it should be. And so, we're in good hands. I have no doubt that we will call a pastor who will continue with that. You know, when I was president of the congregation a number of years ago now, I was really surprised at all of the things that went on in this church. Just spend a week, maybe down in the church office or down in the addition down there, and realize the number of people that come and go, the number of things that are being done in this church. And that's because God has called you to do those things. It's for no other reason. You know, I don't think any of you can say, well, I'm the one who created my faith inside of me. I'm the one who's doing this. No, you've been called to do what you do at this church. And of course, half of the work isn't done, not even half. We have much more work to do. If anything, you know, most churches struggle with their youth. You know, getting the youth to church. What are we going to do with the youth? We have to have the youth. The youth are our future. Well, pray about it. Because it's up to us. It's up to us to follow God's will. God will lead us. I have no doubt about that. He will tell us what to do with our youth. We will bring them up, and they will hear the gospel, and they will believe, and they will continue in this church. Now, of course, our faith is an interesting thing. It's nothing that we just completely have set and say, well, I've gone to church X number of times and I've got my faith set. It's there, it's rock solid, and it doesn't have to change. Remember, faith is a gift given by grace. By grace we are saved, and faith is a gift. And that's sort of illustrated by a story of two young boys on a Christmas morning, 2-3-year-old boys who come running down and see gifts under the Christmas tree. And of course, as 3-year-old boys, they head for the biggest gift first, right? And there's two big gifts, one for each one of them. And they realize, you don't have to tell old boys, you know, opening Christmas gifts, that if there's two big gifts, those are the ones to go for. So they run and they rip the wrapping paper off these gifts. And they realize that they're huge teddy bears. You know, what little kid doesn't love a big teddy bear that they can hug and tackle and roll around with? So they were just thrilled with these teddy bears. And both of them shouted out, "This is my teddy bear." And the parents thought, "Isn't that wonderful?" And it is. What a wonderful gift. But then again, gifts can be taken in different ways. Now, when we look at the story from a different perspective, And this is from a little homily that was given by C.S. Lewis. He said, this is like us human beings when we receive a gift. And if you listen closely, one of the boys said, this is my teddy bear. And the emphasis was on the teddy bear. The emphasis was on the gift. He was so thrilled to have a teddy bear. The other little boy said it a little differently. The other little boy said, this is my teddy bear. The emphasis was on my. And so that's us as human beings. A lot of times we look at, this is my faith. This is something that I have, and I own, and I can do what I want with it. We have to be careful that we focus on the faith as a complete gift that's given to us. It is not to do what we want with it. It is something that we have to pray and listen to what God says to do about it. We don't want to be like Pontius Pilate. He went down in history. He's recited every week in every church in a creed. Why? Because he was the ultimate cynic. He had the Son of God standing right before him. And of course, what was his question? What is truth? There was no thrill there for him. What is truth? If he would have believed, if he would have had the gift of faith, he would have realized truth was standing right in front of him. And so for all of us here at Rushford Lutheran, don't be like Pontius Pilate. Listen to your call. Pray about it every day. Every day ask God, what do you want me to do today? Because the thrill is here. The thrill is hearing the gospel. The thrill is coming to this house. This is God's house. The thrill is listening to God's word, hearing God's word. It is the most powerful thing you will ever hear. It is the most wonderful thing you will ever hear. And then, of course, we gather for communion. We gather God's table. The thrill of receiving the body and blood of Jesus Christ. That, after all, is the truth. Amen.